Hello, welcome back to episode 4. Today I'm going to talk about my favorite aspect of the Castiel prison. It's called the picture plot. Go ahead, enter. I've already opened up a file. It's the jumping fish file. I'll show you how that's done. I press options, file, open. Open the Castiel folder. G3B files are flipbook picture files, which operates similar to video files. Jump down, literally, to the one called Jumpin', short for Jumpin' Fish, and I get the Jumping Fish. I'm going to press Options because I want to show you this thing playing without me doing any plotting of points over the top. I'll press Auto. You're going to watch one fish join its runs in the other bowl by jumping from one place to the other. A few more clicks here. One, and we have splash. That is unique in any other calculator. Nobody else does that. That is such a cool feature. So I'm going to go ahead and start plotting points, which is even better. So what I want to do is I'm going to plot points. I'm trying to look for the center of gravity of the fish because I know that's going to stay constant even as a fish flips and turns through the file. So I'm trying to find relatively the same spot on the fish every single time. All I'm doing is clicking the arrow keys and then pressing execute. And what's happening there is the calculator is recording some information for me. It's calculating an X position, a Y position, and a time component. Again, I'm just going to keep clicking around until I get splashed down, so I got a couple more points to go here. I want to plot as many points as I possibly can to get the smoothest curve possible, to get the best possible fit. Now the last one, I'm going to pick the point at which he enters, because there's a little bit of distortion going on in the picture. It says you're finished, so I'm going to press exit. So now, let me see what kind of options I've got. I'll hit exit to exit this plotting feature. I want to find some kind of a regression equation. So I'm going to find the regression. Looks like a quadratic to me, so I'm going to go with an x squared, which is f3. I'm going to copy that equation into y1. And I'm going to draw. There's my regression equation. There's a little bit of error involved here, but that's okay. It happens with the graph. If I really wanted to, I could go in and edit the individual points to make them fit better. But then that's trying to force my data to fit my graph and not my graph to fit my data, so that wouldn't make much sense to me. So I'm going to go ahead and start doing something with this. Let's take a look at doing some G-solving like we did with other picture files before. When we looked at just strictly pictures, we were able to find the roots. We're still able to find the roots. Here's the first one. Here is the second one. I don't know if you noticed, but I also have the derivative turned on here. I turn the derivative on by going into my setup, which is under my menu. So shift menu. And I go down until I find my derivatives. Got all my different features turned on and off here. Complex mode is real. So somewhere in my modes I've got my derivative turned on, which is all right. I could turn that off later, but I'll leave it on there because I think it's a neat feature to be able to see. Let's look at some other points here. Let's take a look at the maximum point in this curve. If you've noticed so far, I haven't had to do any strange lefted and rights and trying to guesses and things like that like I've seen done in other calculators. This is just a You know, if it's on the screen, if it's in the domain, I can find it, and there it is. Under the gsolve again, I can find the integral for anyone taking calculus. And I just want to find the integral from the roots. So it's going to calculate there's a first root. Well, I press execute, toggle over to my second root, execute, area under the curve. Upper and lower, the area, the integral is the area. Let's see, we could also do some x and y calculations. Let's find a, do a y calculation. When x is 1, I'm out of the domain there, probably because this is a very small area I've got here. Yep. So when x is 1, fish jump from 0 to about 4, so I was going a little bit too far. 0.1, so these are, it's actually 0.4, so the scaling here is really shrunken down a bit, but that's okay. Let's see, what else do I want to do on this one? I want to do some options. I'll exit out of there. I'll press option because one of the features that I really like, besides the fact that it's got video files in it, is that I can transpose the axes. Now, if you have never seen axis transposing, I can show you the graph in terms of time versus x or time versus y. Let me show you the list of data points first. So I just want to take a look at the list. Notice it gives me an x position, a y position, and a time position. So I want to do some axis transposing. Let's look at time versus y. So as time went, what happens to the y? Y looks parabolic. The y position being plotted on the y-axis. If you follow, let's say these are individual seconds, fish did in fact go up and then come back down. Versus, let's take a look at the transpose axis in terms of x and t. In terms of x and t, time was linear, so was the x position. So as time went by, each one of these points followed a very linear pattern. And then if I want to, I can find a regression for that linear pattern. A plus bx, or ax plus b, I'll copy that. I'll put it in the second position here so I don't lose my equation. And take a look, there it is, perfect linear fit. I also have the point link. Point link allows me to link the two points. You notice the two points are flashing in the very first one. Or was it at the second one as time was the second position, time at the third position, time at the next position. Shows you two different relationships in the same window. I could also switch and go back to looking at the regression equation or the point link between the two. I could also cut out individual parts. I could trim the information between two places. So I can do lots of really neat things with this this feature. So let me get out of here. Let's take a look one more time at the regression. This time I'm going to define the graph. I'm going to change how it looks. I'll change the style of the graph. So if you saw some of the earlier videos, you know that you can change the style of the graph. This works exactly the same. Right now it's going to be a dotted line. And I'll just go ahead and draw that in. And there is my dotted regression equation. That's my equation of my x position versus time. So I'll leave that in there because I think that's an important idea and an important concept to talk about and to be able to see in the same graph. But there you have it. My favorite part of this calculator, which is the Casio FX-CG10 or the Casio Prism. It is available at Best Buy and all the major retailers. This is an unbelievably powerful piece of machinery here. If you haven't gotten your hands on one, I would suggest doing that very soon, as soon as you can. Next week we'll take a look at the Run Matrix menu or the Statistics menu. I'm partial to both. But this has been another episode number 4 of the Casio Prism. Take care.